Hey guys, Pasty Boy here. Today we're going to be working on my brother Mark's sled. It's the 2003 Blair Morgan 800. We're going to be pulling the carbs off of it and cleaning them up because we're not sure if we're going to actually change the carbs out or just replace like the jetting and stuff like that. But stick around and find out. Okay, so first thing here, we've Mark pulled the hose off there that's connected to the side panel.
And I'm not doing it again because I don't know if I broke my hand or what, but it's, I don't know how that's even bleeding. There's not even a cut, but I hit it that hard.
Wow. So let's see, he either hit it on a head bolt or this frame. It's probably the bolt because you're bleeding. I think if you would hit that, it would have been more of a bruise.
That hurt.
You're bleeding. All right,
hurt.
But good right. Thing he's got a good pain tolerance.
We're going to take the sliders off so you can take the door or the panel right off. All right, just lift them up.
So these doors, if you have a, you know, first generation Rev, that's how they come off. And we're going to pull the hood off. And we probably will pull the clutch cover off too.
For sure.
Yeah.
We're probably gonna pull the clutch too to get the box
all
out.
All right. So there's a lot to pull off here to get to those carbs. They don't make them like they used to. I mean, that's not necessarily a bad thing, but at the same time, they're so much harder to work on, you know, that everything's in tight and now they're even worse. But so we're gonna see. What's
remember,
next?
My clutch tool wasn't working, and I think I had to use a screw. I'm going to try my clutch tool, but I don't think it works.
All right, so let's grab that clutch tool, and we got to remove the secondary. Okay, so there's something wrong with this clutch tool there that came with the that's in the tool kit. So we just went ahead and grabbed the same thread bolt, and we're going to spread the clutch apart with the bolt. As you can see, that works just fine. All right, next step, we gotta pull the clutch.
So this is 13 mil.
13 millimeter.
It should break pretty easy and then come out easy with your fingers. Now getting it off.
Right.
Oh, all right.
Something fell out.
Yeah. And you got to take off your
little toolbox
yeah,
there.
There's a little snap push button in the back. You got to push it in, take that little toolbox out, a little tab, push in, and bring it up in a diagonal direction.
See if we can get a shot of that happening in here. That's a little slotted thing, yeah. Like a keyhole. Give you a little close-up of that.
So, looks like a washer.
All right, so the next step is to remove the air box. In order to do that, we're gonna have to remove the carb boots here, the little clamps, and looks like one of the let me turn the light on here. One, we're gonna need a really long screwdriver to get way back in there. I don't know if you can see, there's a screw back in there that has to get loosened, and then one right here that has to get loosened, that little band clamp, so we can remove the air box, and then we'll be able to get to the carbs. All right, so we gotta loosen the screw up. Here's the left side, if you're sitting on the sled, boot clamp, or on a boot air box clamp. And then we gotta get to the back one. So we're gonna get that side off. We just gotta get a longer screwdriver to get to the back one. And now that we've got this one loosened off, we can spread it out enough to get inside there, even though we don't have a super long screwdriver. All right, so he's reaching in back there after we've loosened off the this boot. Oh. It's a little tight.
Kind of wiggle it out.
Yep.
Right here, you gotta disconnect that. The wiring?
Yep. Yeah.
It's gotta spread. There. Alright. So you put it in there, spread it, and it'll come off. So now, that comes right out.
Alright. Now we've got pretty good access, I would say.
Yep.
To the air box. What's that hanging there?
Old belt.
Oh, belt fibers.
Yeah.
Not
all
good.
Over.
Yeah, they go all over the place, huh?
Uh-huh.
All right.
I blew three last year.
Wow.
Yep.
All okay. Right.
So now we're going to loosen these two screws. One right here and one on the other boot.
Yep, same type of clamp. They come right off of the reed boots. Those are V-Force 3 reeds. And that's one thing to look out for, guys. If you start seeing cracks in your reed boots here, you're going to want to replace them because they'll start sucking air in and you're going to blow your motor. So we'll loosen those off, and really, that'll get them disconnected.
Yeah,
but then we still have to take all the throttle cables off and stuff in order to properly clean them and see if we're going to rejet or replace. So they're disconnected, and now we gotta disconnect the cables.
All right, so what we're gonna do, we need to loosen these bottom screws, okay? We're gonna loosen those. Then once that gets loose enough, it'll have some slack, then we will be able to, well, I gotta clean all this out so we can see it. See the barrels there on the bottom?
Let me see. It's hard
to see.
It's really hard to see.
See those little barrels? Maybe we can see them from the front better.
Okay. It's hard to see, but there are little cable barrels in there. So once we loose the bottom screws on that bracket and we pull on the throttle, it'll create some slack.
Right here.
We'll be able to
see
remove
these
them.
Little barrels?
Yep.
It'll create some slack. We can push the barrels through.
And then disconnect
and then
the cables.
Disconnect it up here. It'll come slide right out.
All right, let's go ahead and do that. Mm-hmm.
So it is a 10 millimeter. All right, let's get in there, loosen the nut, a couple spins, and it should be able to loosen with your finger at some point.
Now, by loosening the bottom one, that keeps the carb set, the cable set.
Right.
So you won't have to readjust it at all. Leave that top nut alone. All right. We'll pick up when we get to the next step.
All right. I'm going to remove this fuel line because it's kind of in the way. To be honest, I'm not sure if gas is going to come out or not, but we're going to find out in 2 seconds.
Also, be real careful. That just looks like a plastic, like, three-way connector there, and that could snap. So I would take caution when
we'll
removing
take
that.
This line.
All right. So if you just get a little screwdriver, you can kind of... Those are really tight little short hoses, but they'll pop off.
Now we gotta get that main one off. And then a couple of little breathers.
Yeah.
These two.
Again, careful. There are some plastic fittings in there. Wait, oh, that came right off. Guess it didn't really need the, I would pry that too. Oh, that's tight. Tough.
Right,
break
so
one of those, we're screwed.
This.
They're heated.
break one of those, then we just put new carbs on. Gary's got them. Bump has them.
Yeah.
All right, slide that out.
Pry that hose off.
Easier said than done, huh?
Yeah, that thing wants to spin.
Yeah. Oh, and there's the gas.
Yep.
I'm gonna put vice grip ends on here, just in case. I don't know if it's gonna
just
keep flowing or not.
Yeah. Okay. All right, so we just stuck a screwdriver in the end of that hose to block it off, just in case any
see the gas little slot right there? Grab this cable and pull it, okay? And then push it right through the slot. And it should come right out. Just like that.
So, just see the end of that cable barrel there. Show us that. Now you know what you were looking for. There you go. That's it.
All right,
so we're gonna do that on both of them. And then we're gonna disconnect both of these completely from the carburetors, and we'll be working on these on the bench from there on.
That's it. Now you loosen these the rest of the way, and you won't lose the nuts because of the barrel ends. It won't let the nut fall all the way through. All right. That's it. These come out.
Right, so they're through. Just notched.
Yep. See, so the barrel end's not letting the nuts go through. And our carbs are out and right. Filthy.
Let's put them on the bench. All right, so we got to remove the nuts from the bottom of the carb bowls. And apparently there's two fixed jets inside each carb.
17 mil. Let's see if we can break it free. Yep, actually they're not on super tight.
Which is good, they're just aluminum.
Yep. There is one flat slash Phillips screw.
Yeah, so it's a little tiny screw here. One on each. It's a little Phillips.
Nope, that's stripped. So let's try a flat. I got it.
Got it. I think they cut a little slash in that thing.
Mm-hmm. There we go. Yeah, because it is definitely a Phillips head.
Right.
I'll be replacing that screw.
Yeah. All right, so remove that screw, and you can remove the bowl. And just a heads up, there was a ton of gas inside these carb bowls, so
yeah,
be prepared to...
put it in a bucket or a bowl or something.
We got a little oil pan here to catch all that gas. Plus, when you're working on carbs anyway, it's a good idea to put them inside a pan because you're going to be spraying.
And over there, fire extinguisher, keep handy.
Yes. All right, so there's the float. This is
there's a jet in there. If you look all the way down, can you see it?
It's hard to see. Let me see if I turn on my light.
Is that a jet down there?
Yeah.
Gasket. Thank you.